Now, KSPW Weather with Jim Vanderswan.
Just a waiting on a winter time, and so are a lot of other people. Right now, we're still dealing a little bit of winter hints there. Some fog and low clouds in the San Joaquin Valley along the 99. I-5 has been pretty much clear for the night. See a few patches down around Paso Robles on 101. See it there early in the visible satellite, early morning hours. A couple of high clouds going by. That's about as close as we're getting right now. Temperature is actually not all that far from normal. 67 in Boulder Creek and in Watsonville, up to 69 in Scotts Valley with 64, Ben Lomond, Santa Cruz. Still get a few 30s and 40s in the morning time, but not a lot of frost to worry about. Low to mid-60s, as expected, around the peninsula, a little bit warmer in Carmel Valley. Got 68 going for most all of the Salinas Valley, with exception of King City. Got 69 out of KRKC, down to 36 in Soledad this morning. And we got 66 for Hollister and Morgan Hill, 68 in San Jose today. A little bit cooler out in the Central Valley with that inversion layer capping down here, but we're benefiting from a little offshore flow. So is Van Nuys, 73 today, 63 at LAX, 75 in Palm Springs, and still kind of chilly out there in Las Vegas. 68, though, in Phoenix, 40s from Denver all the way back to Seattle, all the way back over to the Dakotas and to Chicago and New York. And then farther south, you start getting the 50s, 60s, even a few 70s, 76 in New Orleans today, so it's rather pleasant there. A few rain showers there. Upper level low, that was nothing for us but a bunch of clouds, is now getting into some moisture. A lot of rain, a couple of thunderstorms, and snow flying over the northern Rockies there around the Denver area. So they're getting a little bit of that. And that upper level low shows up the upper level pattern here. High pressure ridge to the north. This system will slowly make its way out to St. Louis and the Mississippi River Valley. The East Coast is waiting on everything, so easy travel there. Not a lot of issues as far as this is concerned. It's just rainy day weather and not a lot of wind associated with it as well. Meanwhile, you can see how something is taking the path of least resistance. Mountain high pressure ridge, bingo, up goes all the energy right up to Alaska and British Columbia. Next system will suffer the same fate. We may see a few little high clouds drift by. Way out here is another storm that's going to say, well, you know what, I'm going to, instead of going up and over the top, slide in underneath the high pressure ridge and come pay us a visit. It'll look something like this. There's the high pressure ridge. These are lines of equal pressure up at 18,000 feet. And occasionally we see a few little high clouds go by, but nothing that's going to spoil the weekend. Most of that over the weekend on Saturday and Sunday. Then we see this system. Part of the energy starts to work north, but part of this is going to go, wait a minute, we'll push that ridge out of the way and come pay us a visit Monday night into Tuesday. There's your first shot of rain with the bottom end of this trough. The rest of it's to the north. But hey, it's something. At least we'll get some wet out of it, and it'll only last a day or so, it looks like. Meanwhile, we'll keep with that fog out in the Central Valley, maybe a patch or two along the coast, but I don't know. And that east wind will push that out of the mix here rather quickly. So what it boils down to is you got some pretty nice weather coming up here for the next 3 or 4 days in case you need to do something outdoors, like maybe clean the rain gutters or something. Temperatures staying about the same, really. Overnight, 40s and a few 30s. A little chill in some of the valleys. Daytime highs, for the most part, in the 60s. Maybe a 70 here and there, just at the high point of the day, but that's out in the area where they have the long thermometers from about Soledad South. Still is pretty nice stuff for the Salinas Valley. Mid to low to mid-60s around the peninsula, a couple of upper 60s, maybe even 70 degrees Carmel Valley after a nippy morning, and mostly 60s for Santa Cruz County, and again 30s in the morning time, so a little chill there, but snuggle up, cup of coffee, and everything will be just fine. Clear and cold, sunny and mild. That's your Friday. Saturday looking good. We'll call it mostly sunny. Some high clouds, as I mentioned, but a light wind and a basically offshore component, so that's pretty pleasant weather, and we'll get you out of the coolest of the nights here in one night. Monday night, we should be looking at raindrops in the nighttime hours and probably some leftover showers till Tuesday night, so pencil Tuesday in as a rainy day, and that'll be the first time in a month that we've had that. Of course, it's only the second day of February, but we can use all we can get, so we'll see what happens. I don't think this rainstorm is going to stick around long enough to really spoil all the events for the pro-am. Next Saturday, we're keeping an eye on, too. There might be a little something there, but it doesn't look real promising. It's not going to be one of those years where they're going to have to play only three days or something like that.
We're going to have to dodge a few raindrops.
No, yes. Nothing like that.
If we're going to do it, practice round day is a good one.
Yeah, that's a good one to do it, kind of get you in the mood.
All right.
Okay.
All right.